Hey guys, it's Nikki, and in this video I will be explaining what is the difference between use value and an exchange value according to Karl Marx. Sounds interesting? Just continue watching! In the previous video I talked about how the capitalist system works, and I mentioned the word commodity, which in our case was the Ferrari. According to Marx, the commodity has two forms, use value and an exchange value. The use value is all about the quality side of the commodity. Imagine you'd like to have a new phone, but you can buy it yourself, so you try to convince your parents to buy it for you. Of course, you don't want just a regular phone, you want the newest iPhone. So you start explaining to them about all the amazing features this new phone has. At the moment you think you have convinced them, your parents start pulling out of a black box your old phone, tablet, Kindle, MP3 player and say, here, you can use this. Not exactly what you had in mind, right? Because you want the new iPhone, not any of this junk. That's what the use value is, you want exactly that phone, exactly that commodity. The use value fulfills your needs and desires, like you're thirsty, here, have a Coke, or you're cold, here, have a coat, and so on. The exchange value of a commodity is a little bit more complicated, because that's the socially necessary time of labor or work needed for production. Don't panic just yet, it's not so hard to grasp on. Let's go back to the scene with the phone. You don't have the money, but still decide to go to the store and ask nicely for it. I'm pretty sure they would not give it to you. That's because you need to give them something for it. But what? You remember the answer of your parents. But there is nothing similar between the new phone and all the junk from the black box. How they can even compare them? What is the similarity, the one thing they have common? That is that they are all result of work, different kind of, but still work. Now you have the brilliant idea to work at the store and exchange your work for the phone. But how many hours of mopping the floor makes a cell phone? Let's go back to Marx. The question is how many, so it's about quantity. In reality, there is nothing similar between you working at the store and the phone itself. But we know there have to be something, or the capitalism itself would not exist, and moreover, no kind of exchange would exist. Maybe we can make equal your working hours with the hours spent to build the phone. But since it's different kind of work, we need something, like abstract labor, to measure them. For example, it takes fairly 24 hours to make a phone. Do you remember what we said about exchange value? It's the socially necessary time of labor or work needed for production. What that means in our case is that basically at this time and age it takes in average 24 hours to produce an iPhone. One person can do it for 26, another one for 21. But the average between all people working that kind of job is 24 hours. What this also means is that it doesn't matter if you can build it faster or slower, because you can build more or less, but the price for one would be the same unless the average itself change and become less. That can happen, for example, with the invention of a new machine which can make the phone for 20 hours. That's abstract labor, because it's about the average of all people doing that kind of job. The abstract labor is the unit of measure of exchange value. Now all you have to do is find out how many hours mopping the store's floor, the average of all people cleaning floors, equals the 24 hours needed to make an iPhone. Something fun about this exchange value theory is that the air is not considered commodity, because it's free and it does not require work or production, so it doesn't have a value for Marx. But nowadays we have diving cylinders. Yes, it's modified version, but still. When you add human labor to anything, you give it a value. Until then, it's worthless. Okay, enough randomness. Let's go back to the phone. So, you and Marx got it all figured out. You go to the store and start mopping. Just one big obstacle. They have a machine doing that. And you're basically useless. That's the last thing I will talk about. Social use value. Basically, there is a value only if someone needs or desires the result of your labor or work. I'm sorry, you don't get the phone. But at least you have the things from the black box. That's all for this video. In the upcoming video, I will talk more about exchange, money, and the metamorphosis of sale and purchase. So, if you are interested, click onto the Nerdy Bird to subscribe. And if you want to actually read the book, click here. Or just get the whole series from here. If you liked this video, thumbs up and leave me a comment. What do you think? But if you're not feeling like typing, just watch some of my other videos. You might like them. Until next time, bye!